What's up, guys, and welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm showing you an explanation by the Zambia Heritage Conservation Society of Zambia staff as he explains the kind of people that come to see the Chinyunyu hot spring and why they do come, the classes of people. I'm briefly going to tell you, there are people who come as tourists, like those in the bus, which like was just passing there, that one. There are people who come to the hot spring. There are witch doctors which come to the hot spring to come and see this hot spring. There are pastors who come to the hot spring. There are people, traditional people, who come to the hot spring. There are Indians who come to the hot spring. There are Chinese who come to the hot spring. So I want you to sit back, relax, and watch this video. If you are new, subscribe, turn on bell notification, give this video a thumbs up.
Direction of flow of that water. It tells us that water comes from this direction. So what really happens down there, where that water is coming from, is where that water is coming from, there's molten magma and hot lava. Then due to geometrical forces, it formed a fault. A fault in simple terms is a crack. So the heat from the earth crust and the molten magma passes through that fault. When it reaches at the water table, that's when water starts boiling.
It's like just a volcano boils, or something, yeah. A small volcano.
Yeah, so as it boils, it gains pressure now. You start flowing that fault. So that happens to the weaker part of the fault. That's why water managed to find its way out from there. So when you are there, I think you smelled the scent. That
yes.
Smells like boiled eggs. That's because of the composition of minerals. That water is composed of four minerals. There's silica, sulfur, calcium, and manganese. Sulfur is in excess, and it's the one that smells like boiled eggs. So if you drink excess of that water, it stains the teeth. So very good example, as I've said, surrounding villagers here, before that, Bohos, they used to drink that water. So as a result, a lot of people here, they've got stained teeth. Their teeth are brown because of those minerals.
Oh.
But the same water, if you use it for external use like bathing, it's very good for the skin.
Uh-huh.
It nourishes the skin. Even if one has pimples, rashes, or natural sores,
yes,
few of those things because of those minerals. Yeah. So that's scientific.
Okay.
Now, coming to people's beliefs.
Beliefs, people now we want to
so
hear.
So many beliefs about that word.
Yes.
So what will determine your belief is your background. You.
So yeah, I'm sure you background. See pastors here?
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
So how about which
we
pastors?
Have people, uh-huh. I'm coming to that. We have
yes.
people like pastors and prophets. Like, especially this from Pentecostal churches.
Yes.
Then they believe that word is holy. So they normally come here to collect that water, go with it to their churches, pray for it, they
yes.
use it for prayers as holy water.
Hey, hey.
Apart from that, we have churches like Zion churches, our Jawari coach.
Hey, hey.
Them, they say that they say that water has two properties which attracts them.
Uh-huh.
They say that it has healing properties.
Mm-hmm.
Then they believe that it's holy. So it being holy, they use it for baptism. And they've got two types of baptism. They do it from there at the source, just get water in a bucket,
and
pour it on someone. That's what they normally do. I think you will see them. Apart from that, because they also believe that on the same holiness, that water is holy. Downstream there's
yes.
a certain point where the same water collects, smaller like a dam.
Yes.
Where these children are wrapped up, that's
Ooh.
Where they are going for swimming.
Uh-huh.
The temperature there is just warm.
Uh-huh.
So when they take their people there, that side, the Inez, they
oh,
even call it Jordan. That's how they
goodness.
Call it.
Okay.
Then because they also believe that it has healing properties. So they normally come here with those people who are sick or with any different problem. Take them there, make them drink a certain amount, then pray for them.
Uh-huh.
That's what they normally do.
Yeah.
Then apart from that, we have people like the Chinese and the Indians.
Wow.
They believe that
Chinese
that water is good for the skin. So what they normally do there, they normally do a steaming. When one goes there, sit on those stones, cover something. The steam which coming out goes to the body, not until it makes someone sweat. That's when they uncover. That's what they believe. Mind you, there's a lot of steam coming out from there.
Yes,
so all that you've come when it's hot,
uh-huh.
so it goes humidity. As hot as it is, you can't see a lot of steam. But when you come during 8 hours or after sunset, or when the air is saturated with moisture,
there is real steam.
You find
steam.
That all this area will be covered, up the other side of the road, will be covered with steam. So if we were to cover ourselves there just within a few minutes,
you are really sweating.
As if someone has poured water.
And that is scientifically correct. Steaming.
So that's what Indians normally do. Then what those people believe in? Rituals.
Rituals, yes.
Doctors and so forth.
This is what now traditional doctors,
traditionally, people believe that that water is being boiled by the ancestral spirits.
My goodness.
It's good for rituals. Perform the rituals. Before this area was protected, a lot of strange activities used to take place from there. So when you go there, just find, you wonder, find their blood stains, don't know where that blood has come from. Sometimes you find there's a dish with charms inside, meaning someone was bathing medicines at night. Sometimes you find there's a chicken, someone has slaughtered the chicken, pluck it, leave it there as a sacrifice for the ancestral spirits. Sometimes you find their clothes, meaning the owner of those clothes, he or she must either be experiencing a bad dreams, bad luck, bad disease.
Because
bad
even this side, they still found some clothes thrown.
Yeah, being barren. So they'll perform the rituals thereafter and dress. They're leaving the clothes there, having a belief that all those things which trouble them will remain there. Then the ancestral spirits will deal with those problems. That's traditional. Sometimes when you go around these trees, you find some trees are either tied with plastics, or beads. By so doing, it means something to those people who believe in rituals. So that's how that water is being used. But there are so many beliefs. Those are just a few to mention. Then there's a pipe there. That pipe which you saw there, that pipe was fixed there by a certain white man. This white man, his name was Ricardo, was an Italian. He constructed a swimming pool up here. There's a very big swimming pool. It was built out of stones. The swimming pool still exists, but there's no water.
There's no water.
Because the plans of taking water there failed.
Due
to geographical location. Going this side, it's ascending. So, the same white man, the one who fixed that pipe there, across the road, used another hot spring also. So that side, he constructed a concrete slab where people used to sit when bathing. So as time goes, the spring there turned into a cold spring. Water still coming out even now, but it's cold. Okay. So traditionally, as I've said, that people believe that this water is being boiled by the ancestral spirit. So the reason they give to why there, that spring turned into a cold spring, they simply say, because of the construction of the concrete slab, the ancestral spirits were annoyed. Boiling water there. But scientifically, it says it's due to earth movements. If an earthquake or a tsunami occurs, even if it's far away from here, but as long as the earth has been affected, it has been shaken,
it has closed up that crack.
There's a possibility of that fault to close. So when it closes, meaning the heat from the earth crust and the molten magma will be trapped, no longer be reaching where water is. Eventually, it will turn to a cold spring. So scientifically, I think that's what happened that side. Then here, where this hot spring is, this is a Soriland. So it being a Soriland, it has a local name. Locally, they call it Kalungula. Kalungula is a Sori word which means hot. So the two hot springs were shared among the locals, that one and this one here. That one, women used to bath from there, then it was named Kalungula Kamuna. Then ladies used to bath from that side, I mean. Then men used to bath from here. So this is named Kalungula Kamuna, which translates to a male hot spring. The other one, Kalungula Kakazi, that side, which translates to a female hot spring. So that's all about this hot spring. Then the temperature there at the source is about 70 degrees Celsius. The longer the distance water flows, the cooler it becomes.
It is becoming cooler, cooler.
Yeah. By the time it gets at the confluence there, where it joins into that stream, it's just
no more temperature. And the fish can even live now. Because again, what was surprising me is that where the hot water is coming, still more. There's still green grass.
I think on that one, just the adaptation to that kind of temperature.
The vegetation has just adapted due to time.
It was a very good example. You go to deserts, very hot, receives very little rainfall,
but you still trees, which is still survive. Very good. No, I saw that. I saw that in desert there will be a certain kind of tree which will just be withstanding that kind of heat. Thank you so much for the information. Very grateful. It has been very informative. Next time we will. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.